Hello guys, sorry for a long absence, I am working a lot now to make new videos come out more often. It will still take some time, so you'll have to wait. I also ordered some interesting chemicals I want to show you cool chemical reactions with, so don't forget to subscribe to make sure you don't miss it. As for today, I'm going to show you reactions with iodine pentoxide. Iodine pentoxide is a white crystalline powder. This iodine oxide is an anhydride of iodic acid. When heated to 300 degrees Celsius, it decomposes into elemental iodine and oxygen. As iodine pentoxide is the anhydride of iodic acid, it forms iodic acid when reacting with water. Iodic acid is a strong oxidizer and, like nitric acid, gives different reduction products depending on its concentration. In this case, you may see the formation of elemental iodine. In this experiment, I got carbon monoxide by a simple intermixing of high concentration formic and sulfuric acids. One of the key properties of iodic anhydride is its ability to react with carbon monoxide at room temperature, forming elemental iodine, which is easy to see. That's why this property of iodine pentoxide serves as the analytical method for carbon monoxide detection. Look how carbon monoxide burns in air. But only freshly prepared iodine pentoxide can react at room temperature. If it was stored for a long time, carbon monoxide may not react that easily in this case. To start the reaction, iodic anhydride needs to be reactivated with a drop of sulfuric acid. If we stop carbon monoxide supply now, elemental iodine will stop forming as well. See, iodine is not forming anymore, but if we restart the carbon monoxide supply, we'll see iodine forming again. The main point of this video was to show this very well-known analytic reaction of detecting carbon monoxide in the atmosphere but its chemical force. So here is a compilation of interesting chemical reactions with iodine pentoxide you will hardly ever see elsewhere. Iodine pentoxide oxidizes muriatic acid to chlorine gas, forming orange tetrachloroiodic acid. Knowing how violent hydrazine and hydrose reacts with different oxidizers are, I try to drip some hydrazine hydrate on iodine pentoxide. This is how the concoction of aluminum powder and iodine pentoxide burns off. To initiate the reaction with either elemental sulfur or sugar powder with iodine pentoxide, all you need is to touch the mixture with a heated glass rod. A drop of sulfuric acid is necessary for reaction with coal or carbon. And lithium borohydride reacts while stirring. Thanks for watching, guys, and sorry once again for rare releases of new videos in these latter days. You have to wait, but I promise it is worth it. See you soon.